My respectful homage to the Buddha, Dharma and Sangha. Most respected, venerable members of the Mahasangha and Bhikkhunis. Respected, distinguished delegates to this International Conference on Buddhism and Globalization, and dear brothers and sisters. I feel very happy. I am very impressed of the gatherings here in the sense, the quality of gathering. I have been observing number of conferences. Normally the crowd only leads to confusion. Maybe the quality is maybe very important, so it's very highly appreciable. So on this occasion, I take the opportunity on behalf of the Mahabodhi Mahavihara and Bodhgaya Temple Management Committee, here I, along with the Bhante Chalinda, the team of Mahabodhi Mahavihara, we are here. We would like to take this opportunity to welcome you all to the land of enlightenment. And I also would like to appreciate, convey our appreciation and congratulations to the Mahabodhi Society of India, particularly the most venerable. Shivali Thero, the General Secretary and all others associated here for organizing this conference. And I wish it should be every year. But my personal feeling, it should be in a proper way. For your information, every year in Mahabodhi Ashram India, we have the Buddha's Chalice Exposition, the 1st, 2nd, 3rd in February. Accordingly, yeah, another very important dedicated to Buddha, the Bodh Mahotsav, that was under the initiative of the government of Bihar, under the guidance of the government of India. So the Bihar Tourism and the District Administration, along with the Bodhgaya Temple Management Committee, joined by all temples, monasteries here, we have this Bodh Mahotsav celebration. That also earlier, the dates were not fixed. Earlier there was a concern for it could be very important. If the dates are fixed, then the people can plan, well in plan to attend this thing. So here again, we thought it's very appropriate to have the Bodh Mahotsav during the time of the Buddha's Chalice Exposition. So that way, Bodh Mahotsav also is held on 1st, 2nd, 3rd February. Every year, the Honorable Chief Minister of Bihar inaugurates on the evening inaugural session of the Bodh Mahotsav celebration. And after that, we have an international conference on Buddhism. That was mainly organized with the help of all temples here by PTMC. And other thing is the peace prayer. So maybe next year onwards, why not today, we have immediately after 2 days, we have another conference here. It's a very good thing. Near future, maybe it could be, we should have some sort of a joint effort, maybe in a larger scale, maybe jointly BTMC and the Mahabodhi Society of India, and also with the support and cooperation of all the temples here as a lead to have a larger gathering conference and every year so that we can contribute more effectively towards the promotion of Buddha's teachings and Buddha's message worldwide. So on this occasion also, before the welcome speech given by Venerable Shivali ji, and I was just going as a layman, because today this is a very academic place. For us as a layman, speaking on such subject may only contribute to a wastage of time. But we need some sort of a clarification, like Buddhism and globalization. I thought Buddhism globalized means what? Maybe in simple level, because the common people should know Buddhism globalization and to promote the spread of Buddha's teachings, word and teachings and messages worldwide or globally. at least for the benefit of the humanity in this realm, if not the other thing. So on that point, we have been hearing a number of teachings, like particularly just the teachings of His Holiness the Dalai Lama concluded here in Bodh Gaya Cultural Ground. So number of things there, we just have a, as a layman, because the honorable, no, respected venerable monks and all these scholars are the in the process of enlightenment, or the leaders should lead the other laymen or the ignorance towards the goal of perfection. So there are number of issues like His Holiness have been telling, like for the Buddhists, there's a Buddhist religion, Buddhist philosophy, Buddhist science. Buddhist religion is for the Buddhists who practice the Buddhism side by side, Buddhist philosophy and Buddhist science is a universal. Otherwise also practice also is a tradition of Theravadan Buddhism, Mahayana Buddhism. Then again they say the Tantrayana Buddhism. I believe the Tantrayana, all the Vajrayana are the part of Mahayana Buddhism. This is why I understand, may not be correct, maybe accurately. But somehow this time, and then there's a tradition of Pali tradition and Sanskrit tradition. There are a number of things where we are, as a layman, we are not clear, and it will be very good, you know, to have these type of areas. And also the what personal way, with due respect to all the followers and the leaders of the Buddha Dharma. There was a question of like sectarian, you know, I've seen in temple, sectarian way of teaching makes lay people confusion. If some organized Zoom performing different sectarian from geographical area point of view, number of issues are there. So this is my sincere words, what I get, I don't clearly. So these lines, I hope, I wish during these 3 days deliberations, I'm sure definitely that will contribute greatly towards better understanding of the Buddhism and its contribution globally. Once again, I would like to welcome and wish you all a very happy stay here, and also would like to thank the Mahabuddhists of India for giving us this opportunity to stand before you to share my few words. Some of may not be correct, but anyhow, with sincere appreciation and dedication, thank you very much.